Once, after all, he had been a cynic, and his stoicism, perhaps, was a hardening against grief, bringing not only the most sublime ethical system of its time, but its own repose, even gratitude. Observe, in short, how transient and trivial is all mortal life. Yesterday, a drop of semen, tomorrow, a handful of spice or ashes. Spend, therefore, these fleeting moments on earth as nature would have you spend them, and then go to your rest with a good grace, as an olive falls in its season, with a blessing for the earth that bore it, and a thanksgiving to the tree that gave it life. At the age of 98, Zeno died by his own hand. Larnaca, which succeeded Kition, took its name from the ancient tombs and urns, the Larnas, on which it was built. The very heart of the medieval city was a tomb, the traditional grave of Lazarus, who was caught by the Jews after his resurrection in Bethany, so the tradition weakly runs, and placed in a leaky boat to Joppa. But instead of sinking, Lazarus sailed to Kition, where he was consecrated bishop and lived for another 30 years before dying again. While his supposed body was taken to Constantinople in the 9th century, then stolen by the medieval French and shipped to Marseille, the church of St. Lazarus was built above the empty grave, and is lovely still for the patina of its stone. Wandering under its walls, I came upon a little Protestant cemetery with the graves of consuls, missionaries, and members of the English Levant Company, who had mostly died too young in the unhealthy air. Larnaca had been a landing stage for pilgrims as early as the Crusades, and under the Turks it revived as a colony of Western merchants, and above all as the seat of consuls. Here they kept a dusty and punctilious state, lapsing a little into Oriental habits,